Good evening, everyone. I'm in a good mood for two reasons. One, I own zero stock in Bitcoin. And two, we had several marquee matchups in high school basketball, especially on the boys' side. Let's start in Delta County for those games. First, it would be Gladstone back at home tonight, taking on Iron Mountain. First quarter, Braves, they'll turn the ball over, and it's Marcus Johnson who has it. He hangs in the air and gets the layup to go, two of MJ's 35 points on the night. Back the other way, Carson Shea with the three. It rims out, but Shea grabs the board, dishes outside to Rudy Peterson. He tries a three, and this time it goes down for Petey as the Braves get on the board. A little later, Johnson drives, kicks it to Tony Fiera, and the Fireman knocks down the short jumper as the Mountaineers led 8-6. But the Braves would keep attacking. Layup no good for Reese Caster, but this is why we call him Reese the Beast. Basket counts, plus the foul, as Caster matches his jersey number with 44 points tonight. But it wouldn't be enough, as Iron Mountain gets the road win over Gladstone, 71-66. We head over to Escanaba as the undefeated Eskimos welcomed Marquette. Third quarter, Redmen up big and looking to add to it. Ball to the corner for Ethan Martish, and Emarsh buries it as Marquette led by 20. A little later, Ryan Robinette with the ball, and Double R has been on fire this season as he drives on everyone and scores the layup. He led all scorers with 24 points. Moments later, it's another three, this time from Trey McFerrin, and T-Mac knocks it down. He finished with a team-high 21 points. Eske would keep battling though. Quick inbounds pass to Jared Nash, and the jeweler rises up and scores the bucket there. But the Redmen, they were just on fire tonight as they get the conference road win over the Eskimos, 76-53. To the scoreboards, North Central wins their second straight as they top Menominee 57-35. Sophomore Noah Gorzinski led the Jets with 19 points. And it was another big night for Matt Ojala, who dropped 32 points as Calumet knocks off Barriga 71-30. Yes, Ojala outscored the Vikings on his own. Let's go over to the Model Town win hosting Negaunee. Fast start to the first quarter for the Miners. That's Luke the Locomotive Mattson getting Negaunee on the board early, a lead they would not give up. Gwynn relying mostly on Tucker Taylor, and T-Squared lays that one in. He would have a night for him. More on that later on. Negaunee's press was very effective tonight. That's Michael Jackson Sager stealing that one, and he's all alone for the lay-in to increase the lead for the Miners. And T-Squared again for the easy basket here. He was tough to stop tonight. 31 points would lead the team, but Negaunee would be too much to handle as Jason Sensation Waterman finds the basket. He also scored 31 as the Miners go on to win this one, 62-45. Let's check out the girls' scoreboards now, as Kearney NATO hangs on to beat Norway 38-36. North Dickinson gets the win over Big Bay Dinac 56-43. Julianne Wickman led the Nordics with 20 points. It was Forest Park 46, Superior Central 32, and Munising has no trouble with Newberry. The Lady Mustangs get the win 69-15 as they go into Christmas break with a 6-0 record. Let's head to Westwood for some girls action. Patriots hosting Gladstone. Opening possession for the Pats, Marissa Corello with a quick pass to Aiden Christmas Wreath, and she gets it to go. Westwood has the first basket of the game. A little later, defense becomes the name of the game. Tessa Lease gets the steal there. Tessa Beast takes it all the way to the rack. She had 8 steals to go along with 17 points and 10 rebounds. Moments later, it's Caitlin Too Slick Hardwick with the nice layup there, but just stick with the play as Hardwick gets back on defense and she'll poke the ball away, and defense leads to offense as she gets another layup opportunity and makes good on it. Braves with a nice lead early on. Closing seconds of the first quarter, shot here is no good, but Andy the Baller Ballinger scores at the buzzer for Gladstone. However, it would be Westwood getting the win tonight, 53-28. And one hockey score to report as Dawson McKay scores the go-ahead goal in the third to give Houghton a 3-2 win over Calumet.